Well, this is Bobby at Propel TV Repair with a brief educational video about a problem with Samsung UN46EH5000F, and I'm sure all other ones based on the same power supply, which is BN44-0667A. The set came totally dead, no standby, no nothing. The main fuse was open, no continuity. And because fuses rarely fail by themselves, further investigation found the driver transistor for the power factor correction circuit. And I'm sorry, I don't see the number here. This one, it was shorted. And those rarely short by themselves as well, but we did not find anything else. So we replaced the fuse, replaced the transistor, put the board in, and it started sparkling here. The backlight came up as it normally should, but it was sparking here, and the board got a little toasted. You can't see much of that, but we turned it off quickly enough. This was all clean. And for a while there, couldn't find the source of the problem. Turns out this is what it was. That's the second capacitor here in the row above the transistor. You can see the little, a very miniature dot on the lower left. This is where it broke. And this is where it must have been sparking from. This transistor is still working good. Probably if we had left it on, it would have failed again. Whatever the reason, I'm gonna put back a new capacitor and put the board on video again. Hopefully it will work fine this time, and then we'll make a repair kit. And this is why it is important that you replace sometimes things. This is a general problem with kits that I see, say from Shop Jimmy. They throw in so many parts that you don't need and that I have never seen fail. They will give you, you know, the diodes here, which may sometimes fail, even though 1 in 100 maybe. They may give you these diodes. They will give you lots of ICs. They give you a lot of different parts, but, you know, it's still up to you to decide what you need and what you have to replace. With the kits that we do, we try to give and include all the parts that we have seen actually fail in a particular board. And replacing more is a waste of time and introduces initial risk, but replacing less, like in this case, also introduces a risk. So there is no silver bullet for people who are more capable of diagnosing properly. You get more parts that's better vetted for you. You decide which one you need, even if some of them you will never ever need, because it's so much easier to charge whatever $20-$30 for a repair kit that includes 10 components, and then for one that has 2 or 3. Anyhow, hopefully this helps someone. Good luck in your troubleshooting. I'm gonna put that thing now, make a pause, and record more maybe, or just upload it as it is. Here is the continuation, now with a replaced capacitor. The one that we put is 2 kilovolts as opposed to the original one. We always substitute with bigger. The resistor that is here is also not the original. It is from the same family, but it's a higher voltage, higher current. I think the original one was 600, this was 750 at 18 amps versus the original 13. Whenever we have to buy, we just buy the bigger and bigger and better. To us in repair services, that doesn't matter. To production, when you have hundreds of thousands of them, it does. So this is it. The board is working fine. The TV will also be working fine. I still haven't screwed it up, but hopefully this will help somebody time and money. We will make a repair kit posted on our website. Look at it. Look for it there. Thank you.